You may be surprised at the number and variety of fixtures that are needed for PCB manufacturing. Our manufacturing engineers design fixtures to serve many purposes, but the common goal is to make it easier for the assembly team to do their jobs with consistent high quality. A lot of fixtures are used for component placement and soldering. This fixture helps move these long, flexible boards through the surface mount process. It holds them flat as they go through solder paste, pick and place, and reflow. Cutouts allow all areas of the board to reach the optimal thermal profile in the reflow oven. It is machined from Durastone, a material that can go through the 260 degrees C reflow oven thousands of times without degrading. These composite material fixtures are also used to carry boards through the SMT process. You can see the darkening effect from many trips through the reflow oven. Here's a fixture made of Durastone and titanium for wave soldering. The surface mount components are already bonded using reflow, and now the fixture holds the through-hole pins in place for a trip through the wave solder. The fixture also masks specific areas where there are holes we don't want filled with solder. Here's another wave soldering fixture with a spring-loaded base to eject the board. We also use off-the-shelf fixtures made of titanium that we can adjust to carry different size boards through the wave solder. Here's a fixture we designed for robotic soldering. The flexible boards we saw earlier get a through-hole LED added after reflow, and it is soldered using robotic selective soldering. Most hand soldering work also needs some kind of fixture. This one holds the board steady while keeping the underside components up off the work surface. Another fixture we designed holds LEDs in place at very specific angles for robotic or hand soldering. Our electrical design engineers also use soldering fixtures when we design and develop prototype boards for our customers. This commercial fixture is flexible enough to hold many different boards. We use fixtures for many other tasks besides soldering. For example, this robot dispenses a thin line of glue around the edge of this lid for a customer's product housing. With a standard grid and spring mount, the fixture is easily adjustable for many different work pieces. Our manufacturing engineers use their knowledge of manufacturing processes to design fixtures that help the assembly team do their work more efficiently and with consistent high quality. They work with our electrical engineers to develop comprehensive test fixtures, like this one, which does a full functional test of a customer's board. And this one, which is used for 6 different part numbers. It automatically measures a voltage to detect which model is under test. Fixtures at Z-axis go through validation to ensure that they are doing what they are designed to do. For example, this fixture is used to make sure a length of bare wire is within spec. Validation makes sure that the fixture matches the print. Fixtures get preventative maintenance and validation at least annually. Fixtures can be expensive, but the investment in designing and making a fixture is paid back many times over in process efficiency and quality. Our manufacturing engineers work to make fixtures as cost-effective as possible. For example, they designed this one double-sided, so it can be used with 2 different boards. We can use 3D printing to produce economical prototype fixtures, and with the new materials available, they are suitable for many production uses as well. Check out our related videos to see fixtures at work in the SMT process, thermal profiling, soldering, and more. And contact us to learn more about PCB assembly manufacturing at Z-axis.